Hey guys, it's Greta here, Ladies Relationship Coach. And today, ladies, let's talk about, let's say you messed up and you slept with him straight away, one night stand, second date, something like that. And you decided that you really like him and you want him to make into your boyfriend, right? So is it possible to do it? And how does this work? And so on, right? So, the good news is, yes, there is a big possibility that you can make him into your boyfriend. The bad news is, it's going to be much more difficult than, let's say, you would do things right from the start, right? And let's say it would prolong the sleeping with him and stay a challenge from the beginning and all of that. So, the reason it's hard, it's because his goal, because he's attracted to you, right? He doesn't really care about the emotional stuff just yet, but he's really attracted to you. So the guy's goal is to get what you have, you know, as they say, the cookie. And as soon as you're gonna give him the cookie, it's like his goal is accomplished. He becomes not that interested in you emotionally or what you've got to say or how you are as a woman. And what happens is guys usually dump girls like that very quickly. Or even if we are giving them a chance, they kind of like, we just pick on something that we don't like. The most ridiculous sign in the world, like for example, she texted me after 11 p.m. That's not good enough. I'm dumping her. You know, over the slightest dislike, he is feeling completely free to dump you because he's not emotionally attached to you, right? You are because you just slept with him, but he is not because it doesn't work with him like that. However, there is still a possibility. I would say when things like that happen, when you get a one-night stand, concentrate on being a challenge. This is the only way, girls. So let him text you first, let him call you first. Don't see him, try really avoiding seeing him after 11 o'clock. Don't start saying things like, oh, I don't wanna sleep with you anymore, let's just meet like that during the daytime. He'll be like, well, you slept with me already, so what's the point of that? Be a bit more clever with it, you know, say, instead of saying, I don't wanna have sex with you anymore, say something like, oh my God, I'm so sorry, I'm so busy at 11, but I could meet you at 7. And then when you get to 11 o'clock, tell him like, oh my God, I have such an early night and I need to go home. I need to have a good night's sleep. So at the end of the day, he spends the time with you. Let's say you bring out your best self, you're charming, you're fun, you're being yourself, you're having a good time. And then you go home, right? You don't tell him that like, oh no, I'm not sleeping with you anymore. That was a mistake. You just kind of escape from it gently. And again, you let him pursue you, you let him chase you, you don't talk about your feelings, you don't wear the heart on the sleeve as I'm saying it. You're kind of like, you have to be crazy strong and crazy in control of your emotions. You don't question the relationship, you don't say anything, where is this going, what do you feel, what do I feel, none of that. You just stay as cool as you possibly can, because the truth is, when you're in control of your emotions, he starts questioning how you haven't fall for him yet, how come you're not talking about your feelings yet. I mean, he got sexually involved with you, he is taking you on the dates and all of that, and you're still withholding your feelings, you know. So stay strong. And when you will keep doing that, he will start losing his. He will start getting that emotional control and connection with you and getting his feelings deeper and bigger for you because you're staying a challenge, because you just became a goal. Now he doesn't want just your body, now he wants your heart. There is another goal here, right? So it's really important to control your emotions, you know, like not to act needy, clingy, controlling, possessive. Don't question him. Show that you are enjoying his company and you're having fun with him, but no jealousy scenes, nothing like that. You guys are not in a relationship. And then slowly, 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 I would give if I'm in this position, I would give myself about 3 months at doing things completely right, like nailing it, you know, control of discipline, you know, control of my emotions, not texting, not calling, no jealousy, nothing like that. Set him completely free. When you set a guy completely free, this is when he wants to trap you in a relationship with him. When you go and try and control the guy and you tell him what to do, this is when he wants to escape and he goes like, oh my God, she's crazy, I'm running, I don't want a relationship, I'm not ready for it, I'm not a commitment type of guy, I'm still in love with my ex and all that type of, you know, stuff. So yeah, give yourself 3 months and do things right. Do everything to make it right. I know it's super hard. I've been there. Now it's like automatic. I don't even think about these things. But at the beginning, it is really hard and you have to do it. And it does work. I have more than a few clients who had one night stands. The guys lost interest in them. And now we have amazing relationships. So it is possible, but it does not work every single time. If his goal was just your cookie and he's not interested anymore, unfortunately, there is nothing else that you can do. However, in nowadays kind of society, guys usually still give a chance because there is so many easy girls that it's just like kind of became like everyday thing. But yeah, but the better way would be if you're holding it and you're like doing things properly. However, there is still a chance that you can still have an amazing relationship with him if you get stuck at doing things completely right, nailing things after you had sex with him after a one-night stand. Okay, so ladies, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed my video. If you liked it, please press like and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I also answer the first question completely free. So just WhatsApp me your question if you live abroad to 0077021960555, and if you live in the UK to 0770219605, and have a lovely day and let me know what you think in the comments below. Love you loads.